Our workshop is about city planning, sustainable city planning. And in that workshop, we explore ways to link formal and informal worlds. Because on the one hand, we need formal knowledge, because there's a lot of knowledge out there about how to build cities more sustainable. But on the other hand, we need to link to informal worlds, to local knowledge, to local histories, to local infrastructures. I think together, that will build more resilient cities.
We need to come from trade-off to synergy. To do this, a better understanding of local urban dynamics is needed. From our case studies, we learned that issues vary from context to context, and solutions are locally embedded.
As we experience in the Philippines, we have this kind of issue that managing risks about environment and livelihood of the people, especially working with the informal and informal sector. But with all the consultation or in our awareness raising and involving people to understand their risks and assess and analyze and plan it itself, it help us to bridge this informal and formal sector.
People in the community will not understand that climate risk projection for 30 years. They wanted how to eat every day.
I think urbanization, particularly in developing country, it comes with both positives and negatives. Positive is because it brings a lot of opportunity, improves the standard of life. But in terms of negative, one of the biggest challenges is that because the pace of urbanization and the pace of service delivery doesn't match, and therefore there is a lot of inequity to access of important resources like water. Climate change, which is also a big challenge at the moment, which is making water resources scarce. So this inequity is actually increasing more. So therefore, there is a strong linkage between urbanization, inequity, and climate change.
When we try to talk about various framework, if we only focus on the urban areas, we are actually not getting the entire picture, because we might make our cities or the urban areas extremely sustainable, but that sustainability cost could be very high for the peripheral areas.
Bringing the stakeholders together between informal, formal communities is a process that is difficult and complex, and it needs trust between the stakeholders, because often they don't know each other, they don't know each other's interest. And this needs time as well.
From the chordate perspective, climate change is more than rising seawater levels or droughts. It is causing conflicts, or at least is accelerating them. It will make conflict more likely to happen. This will especially take place in cities.
So we really invest in a lengthy process to ensure that everybody's heard and understood, and all interests are taken along into a plan and into an analysis.